Hello, I am Heidi Benjaminson, and I am a certified life coach, and I am thrilled that you have decided to take this 3-video course on how to love your teenager. I work with a lot of clients who have struggling relationships, some at work, but some in their families, and a lot of them have asked me how they can access more love for their teenagers. How can they help them? How can they be the best parent that they can be in these years? I want you to know that I am a mother of teenagers. I have 2 teenagers and 1 almost teenager. And I have found these tools to be so helpful for how I can feel the emotions that I feel and for the emotions that we have in our home. And I've been able to see my children react in ways so differently when I am really using these tools and implementing what I have learned to manage my brain and my emotions. I think that teenagers are a great gift. I don't believe all this stuff in the world about, oh, teenagers are so bad. I think that they are learning and growing in amazing ways. This world is changing. They have to adapt so quickly. And I feel like parenting teenagers is really where I am accessing the most love, the most patience, where I'm figuring out where my most deficiencies are. So it's hard, but it's worth it. This is great, great work that we're doing. Now, something I want you to know is that we can't change other people. Now, lots of times we want to change or we want other people to act in a certain way. And when our children were younger, we could maybe force them to go places or do something. I don't know if your children are like mine. They're now a lot bigger than me. I can't force them to go or to do certain things. So just knowing that we don't have that control really allows us to loosen our grips on what we're thinking and what we're expecting of them. Now, in this first video and in the first exercise in the worksheet, I want you to have a lot of awareness. And when I say awareness, lots of times people want to look outside and be aware of what other people are doing or how they're thinking and guess about it. But this time I want you to go inside your head and I want you to now get a lot of awareness of what you're thinking about your child, about your teenager. What are you thinking they're doing right? What are they doing wrong? What expectations do you have? What disappointments do you have? Are they a certain way and you thought that all your children would be a different way? Are you maybe feeling insecure about raising a child that has maybe different strengths or different struggles? I want you to fill up the whole page. Give yourself some time to think about everything that you're thinking about them. And then I want you to look at that whole page and I want you to give a title to what this chapter in the story of their life is. What is the title that you think of when you look at all this? Now, here are some examples of different titles that different people might have. My 14-year-old is a very difficult child. Or my 17-year-old is sexually active and I think they're ruining their life. Or my 16-year-old is suffering from debilitating anxiety. So I want you to just quickly write down what the title would be, because often that title is what comes into our mind when we think about that child. It's kind of a subconscious thought or sentence that runs through. And it really controls how we feel about this child and how we act. And that is what's staying in the, is really stopping us from feeling the emotions and the love that we want to. So do this work, and I'm going to see you in video 2.